GGO, we was over.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah.
A country who has the number 7 producer of crude oil but have no refinery.
Yes.
A country where the president cannot even come and address the people when they are throwing conspiracy.
Yeah,
but instead, send his DSS after innocent people.
Yeah.
The same DSS could not get rid of Boko Haram. The same DSS could not get rid of Fulani Heads. What country are we talking about?
Yeah.
What country are we saying we are proud of?
Mm.
Fellow Nigerians, we are calling on you. It's time for you to stand up for what you want. It's time for you to stand up for justice.
Yeah.
This is not about any single individual. It's about us as a country.
Yeah.
It's about us as a people.
Yeah.
It's about us as people who have dignity.
Yeah.
It's about us as people who want to be respected in the international scene.
Yeah.
That is why we are standing up today, calling on the government to release Omoyele Sowore, to release every other political detainee. Enough is enough of this shenanigans. Enough is enough of this pretending. Enough is enough of this darkness. Enough is enough of this injustice. Enough is enough of the government who are not tolerant to democratic principles. Enough is enough of government that believe the only way it can rule the people is through the barrier of God. We can no longer tolerate this government. Look, the reason why we are standing here today, we've had 59 years of continuous government failure. That is why we are saying we cannot continue to tolerate it. We cannot continue to tolerate business as usual.
Yeah.
We cannot continue to tolerate where senators are earning 30,000 but we cannot pay $100 to our workers in a month.
Yeah.
We cannot continue to tolerate a government that cannot even treat themselves in the country.
Yeah.
We cannot continue to tolerate government officials who send their children to school abroad, whereas school in Nigeria is the state of men.
Yeah.
We cannot continue to tolerate a government that travels by helicopter.
Yeah.
The roads of the country is in a mess.
Yeah.
We cannot continue to tolerate a government that spends more than 50% of its budget to pay salaries. We cannot construct roads.
Yeah.
We cannot build hospitals.
Yeah.
We cannot build schools.
Yeah.
To the point that we cannot even feed ourselves.
Yeah, so.
We cannot continue to tolerate a government like that. Nigeria has 59, we are not to be proud. Nigeria has 59, we are not to be happy about.
Shame.
It's a shame.
Shame.
So if you believe you have enough of that shame, this is the time for you to stand up. This is the time for you to stand up and be counted. Like we said, we are in front of the Nigerian High Commission.
Yeah.
We are calling on the Nigerian government.
Yeah.
We are calling on the traditional rulers.
Yeah.
We are calling on the religious leaders. We are calling on every Nigerian who will be one who still have any sense of pride to stand up and be counted. To stand up and be counted. Enough is enough of fooling ourselves. Enough is enough of deceiving ourselves. Enough is enough of living in this shambles. Enough is enough of living in this injustice. That is why we are calling on the Nigerian government.
When I remember no light,
water run away me, ayo, 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 water run away me, ayo.
Revolution without
ammunition.
Revolution without
ammunition.
Revolution without
ammunition.
We're asking Free Sowore and every other political activist that have been wrongfully detained by the Nigerian government illegally for speaking truth to power. When has it become crime to ask the governor for good governance? When has it become crime to ask the governors for to give us what we voted them to do?
Yes.
You know, 2 days ago was election. What were we celebrating? We celebrating the good roads?
Nothing.
We celebrating good roads? No. We're not celebrating electricity. We're not celebrating. We're not celebrating employment. We're not celebrating good schools. There's nothing is working. That's why we are asking the federal government for revolution. When we say revolution, we mean a change.
We mean a change.
We mean a change of the mindset. We mean a change of it. We need economic freedom. We need social change. Political change. We want Buhari to stop doing what he has been doing before. Well, that's why we say revolution. Revolution means don't do what you have been doing before that didn't give you a good result.
Exactly.
So now we need him to do it. If we want revolution, if we want Buhari out, we will be shouting Buhari must go. But we say revolution now, we need change. That's what we want. And we don't beg for it. We are demanding, we are asking for it. Because it's our fundamental human right. We are asking for it. We are unapologetically asking for it as Nigerians. Nigeria belongs to everybody. It doesn't belong to just a few cabals or a few friends. That's why we are asking for revolution now and free sovereign now.
Revolution leyi o ebi para ilu she revolution leyi she democracy leyi she democracy leyi o ebi para ilu she democracy leyi she government leyi she government leyi o ebi para ilu she government wa leyi solidarity forever solidarity forever solidarity forever we shall always fight for our rights solidarity forever
revolution without
ammunition.
Revolution without
ammunition.
Revolution without
ammunition.
What do we want?
Revolution
without ammunition.
What do we want? Revolution. What do we want it now?
What do we want?
Revolution.
When do we want it now? What do we want?
Revolution.
When do we want it
now?
What do we want?
Revolution.
When do we want it
now?
What do we want?
Revolution.
When do we want it
now?
What do we want?
Revolution.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Revolution.
And when do we want it?
Now.
Free Sowore.
Now.
Free Sowore.
Now.
Free all the activists.
Now.
Free all the activists.
Now.
Free all the activists.
Now.
Sowore must be
free.
Sowore must be
free.
Sowore must be
free.
Sowore must be
free.
The government must accept the bare conditions. The government must accept the rule of the court.
Oh, yes.
They must accept it. They cannot go by it.
It's chaos.
Yes. They cannot.
If you don't preach your word,
If you know we should, oh, Yahweh, go God.
Another challenge you, double challenge you.
Free to water now. Revolution without ammunition. We are tired of bad governance.
Oh, yes.
We are tired of crooks in power.
Oh, yes.
We are tired of tyrannical governance.
Oh, yes.
We are tired of people like Buhari and Osinbajo. All of them, they must go.
Oh, yes.
They are terrible for that nation.
Oh, yes.
We are tired of injustice.
Oh, yes.
They must obey the court decision.
Oh, yes.
The court decision says, give Chiwele bail.
Yes.
They must honor that decision.
Oh, yes.
They need to honor it. They can't override it. They can't go by it. They cannot be above that law.
Yes.
We demand that the government complies with the judgment of the court.
Yes.
They cannot go and say to us, oh, start another court, judgment.
Yes.
This is injustice. It's a travesty of justice for that to happen.
Yes.
Every single Nigerian that's hearing me, play your part.
Oh, yes.
Because today is your water, tomorrow it can be you.
It can be you. Yes.
We need to stand up now. Free your water.
Now.
Free your water.
Now.
Also, free Olawale Bakare.
Now.
Free Olawale Bakare.
Now.
Free Jalingo.
Now.
Free Jalingo.
Now.
Free Jalingo.
Now.
Bakare.
Now.
Free your water.
Now.
Free your water.
Now.
Free all the other activists.
Yes.
This is injustice going on. And we mustn't be silent in the face of injustice.
Oh, yeah.
We cannot afford to be silent.
Oh, yeah.
We are back in the 80s.
In the face of darkness.
Exactly.
Be silent in the face of tyranny.
Exactly.
We mustn't be silent in the face of oppression.
Precisely.
We mustn't be silent in the face where the executive trample on the judiciary.
Oh, exactly.
We mustn't be silent with a government that continues to flaunt the rule of law.
Exactly.
And want the citizen to obey the law.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Where there is no law, there is chaos.
Oh, exactly.
Where there is no law, there is anarchy.
Exactly. Oh, yes.
Where there is no law, there is disaster.
Oh, exactly.
That is why we are calling on every Nigerian.
Yes.
That is why we are calling on everybody, no matter who you are. If you still regard yourself as a Nigerian, if you still regard yourself as somebody that have dignity, if you still regard yourself as somebody that see the need to stand for justice, we are calling on you today.
Oh, yes.
This is not the time to be on the fence.
Oh, yes.
We said it times with that number.
Yes.
And we will continue to say it.
Yes.
This is not the time for us to pretend.
No.
This is time for us to say it doesn't have nothing to do with me.
Exactly.
It has everything to do with you. As long as you are within that confinement called Nigeria, it has something to do with you. As long as you call yourself a citizen of that country, it has everything to do with you. If the Nigeria pay, it pay for all of us. If Nigeria is good for all of us. Enough is enough of pretending. Enough is enough of deceiving ourselves. The only way we can move forward is to sell ourselves the truth. The only way we can move forward is for us to be honest with ourselves. If Buhari wants to be honest with himself, he should come out and address the nation. He should come out and tell the country why he continues to flaunt the rule of law. Like we've said before, where there is no law, there will be chaos. Where there is no law, there will be anarchy. Nigeria belongs to every Nigerian. Nigeria does not belong to any single individual.
It
doesn't matter who you are. You have to stand up and fight for your rights. This same Buhari overthrew a democratically elected government by God in 1983. If Buhari wants to be honest with himself, he should come out and tell us why he did that. He should come out and be honest with himself. He should come out and tell us what he has been doing by trampling on the rule of law. He should come out to tell us why we continue to have darkness in that country.
He
should come out to tell us why they cannot pay the minimum wage of $100. And himself and the senators are getting away with all kind of atrocities. He should come out to tell us why we have to borrow money to pay salary.
He
should come out to tell us why we don't have roads.
Yes.
He should come out to tell us why we have 15 million children out of school.
Yes.
He should come out to tell us why we cannot secure ourselves.
Yes.
He should come out to tell us why chaos are roaming the streets.
Yes.
He should come out to tell us why kidnapping has become the order of the day. He should come out to tell us when he's able to send DSS after activists, but he cannot send the same DSS
after Boko terrorists. Haram. He cannot after send the same DSS after Mieti Allah. He cannot send the same DSS after kidnappers. But he's sending DSS after innocent people.
Yes.
That is why we will not be quiet.
No.
We will not be intimidated.
Yes.
We're going to stand on the principle of rule and justice.
Yes.
To demand for what is right for us.
Yes.
To demand for Nigeria to be transformed.
Yes.
To demand that enough is enough of darkness.
Yes.
Enough is enough of government failure.
Yes.
Enough is enough of government deceiving its citizens.
Yes.
Enough is enough of pretending that nothing is happening.
Yes.
Whereas the country is going down.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
At 59, Nigeria cannot feed himself.
No.
At 59, Nigeria cannot provide electricity.
Oh, yes.
At 59, Nigeria cannot boast of good road.
Yeah.
At 59, Nigeria has no airline. At 59, Nigeria cannot boast of a single refinery.
Oh, yes.
Despite being one of the biggest producers of crude oil in the world.
Oh, yes.
Buhari should come out why these things are still like this.
Oh, yes.
When Buhari came to power, he promised us change.
Yes.
Is it the change we want to see?
No.
Is it the change that he promised us?
No.
If this is the change he promised us, he should come out and explain to us.
No.
Because this is not the change we have envisaged.
Exactly.
This is not the change we look forward to.
Yes.
This is not the change we look forward to when you trample on the rule of law.
Yes.
This is not the change we look forward to when you cannot obey the judiciary.
Oh,
this is not the change we look to when you intimidate and send your DSS after people who are demanding for their civic rights.
Yes.
This is not the change we demand for when we have no medical care.
Exactly.
This is not the change we demand for when we are being killed left and right.
Yes.
Within and outside of the country, Nigeria has become a laughingstock.
Oh, yes,
Nigeria citizens have no respect anywhere we go.
Yes.
When we are not being killed, we are being deported.
Oh, yes.
That is why we are coming, we are out here today to demand that enough is enough.
That's
why we are here today to demand that we should put an end to this tyranny.
Yes.
That's why we are here today to demand there should be education for our children.
Yes.
That's why we are here today to demand there should be medical care for every citizen of Nigeria.
Oh, yes.
That's why we are coming here to demand today that is enough of having a road that is like death trap.
Yes.
That is why we are coming here today to demand enough is enough of seeing police and army fighting on the street.
Oh, yes.
This can only happen in Nigeria.
Oh, yes.
It's only in Nigeria you cancel election 5 hours before the election.
Oh, yes.
It's only in Nigeria where people who speak for their rights are being detained.
Oh, yes.
And terrorists are being compensated.
Oh, yes.
Enough is enough of we seeing our government officials taking photos with terrorists.
Oh, yes.
Where that they cannot tolerate those that are demanding for their civic rights.
Oh, yes.
It's through a democratic process.
Oh, yes.
Enough is enough of a government that believes the only way he can rule the people is through intimidation.
Oh, yes.
We are not going to be intimidated.
No.
We're going to stand up and speak until our voice is heard.
Oh, yes.
We are calling on everywhere, meaning Nigeria, wherever you are in the world, go to your embassy.
Oh, yes.
Go and demand for your civic rights.
Oh, yes.
Those of you at home, stand up and be counted.
Oh, yes.
Stand up and be counted.
Oh, yes.
We had all kind of trade unions in Nigeria. The Nigeria Bar Association, your rights and your duty have been trampled on.
Yes.
Then what are you still standing and waiting?
Yes.
The labor unions, what are you still standing and waiting?
Yes.
When your right is being trampled on a daily basis.
Oh, yes.
When your life has no meaning. When the life of a cow is being valued more than your life.
Yes.
What are you still standing and waiting
for?
This is the time for you to start.
Yes.
From your house,
yes.
From your street,
yes.
From your ward,
yes.
From your local government,
oh, yes.
From your state.
Oh,
demand
yes.
For what right it belongs to.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Nigeria does not belong to Buhari and his cohort.
Oh, yes.
Nigeria does not belongs to Tinubu and his cohort.
Oh, yes.
Nigeria does not belong to Osinbajo and his cohort.
Oh, yes.
Nigeria does not belong to Oshomole and his cohort.
Oh, yes.
Nigeria does not belong to APC and his cabal.
Oh, yes.
Nigeria belongs to me and you.
Oh, yes.
Nigeria belongs to everyone.
Oh, yes.
We must stand up and demand for our right in the democratic process.
Yes.
We cannot longer tolerate a government that cannot obey the rule of law.
Yes.
Like we've said before, even in nature there is law. In every society where there is no law, there's going to be anarchy.
Oh, yes.
There's going to be disaster.
Yes.
In order for us to abandon chaos,
yes.
That is why we are calling on every Nigeria, stand up and be counted.
Yes.
Stand up and be counted.
Oh, yes.
We demand the release of Omoyele Sowore.
Yes.
We demand the release of every political detainee.
Oh, yes.
But if a Buhari wants to heal the nation, Buhari should be calling on everyone, holding a meeting,
yes.
Having a negotiation with everyone,
yes.
On how we can move Nigeria forward.
Oh, yes.
There are different agitations in every corner of the country.
Oh, yes.
From the Boko Haram to Biafra, everybody is agitating.
Oh, yes.
Because of the failure of governance.
Yes. Oh, yes.
If we think we will continue in this process, I wonder what's going to happen to us in the next few years.
Yes.
As Nigeria as it is today, it's a failed state.
It
is time for us to renegotiate what it takes to be a Nigerian.
Yes.
It is time for us to negotiate if we want to obey the rule of law or not. Nigeria is 59 years old, but nothing to ride on my back. Nigeria is 59 years old, we are still in that slavery. Nigeria is 59 years old, we cannot even uphold the rule of law. We are calling on everyone, traditional rulers, religious leaders, market women, whoever you are, Nigeria belongs to you. This is the time for you to stand up. We are here doing our bit so that our voice will be heard. We are not calling for any violence. We are calling for your civic right to be obeyed. Are calling for your democratic right to be obeyed. We can no longer tolerate a government that cannot tolerate questioning. They can no longer tolerate a government who refuses to be accountable to its citizens. Nigeria does not belong to them. Nigeria belongs to all of us. So you have every right to question them when things are not going right. Like I said before, Buhari lead a military coup to overthrow a democratically elected government. Because he feels the direction the country was going is bad. He used that, he did that by the barrel of gun. We are not doing this by the barrel of gun. We are doing it through a civic disobedience. We are calling on every trade union to stand up in Nigeria. We are calling on every Nigerian in diaspora to stand up and be counted. Go to your embassy. Demand for your rights. Speak for the truth. If it is not you today, it's going to be you tomorrow. In my opinion, like the way it is now, it's already all of us. We are all already affected. Bad road does not know ethnicity. Bad road does not know your religious affiliation. Lack of school does not know ethnicity. Lack of school does not know your religious affiliation. The road that you travel on, like a death trap, does not know your ethnicity. Insecurity does not know your ethnicity. Boko Haram is killing, they are killing everybody indiscriminately. Whether Yoruba man, Igbo man, Hausa man, Muslim, Christian, whatever you believe in. Boko Haram doesn't want to know. They kill you, they kill you. So if you want to see an end to all this tyranny, if you want to see an end to all this chaos, this is the time for you to stand up. This is the time for you to be counted. As you want to see now. Revolution now.
Before we go, revolution. Forever, we shall always fight for our rights. So this another challenge, another challenge, any challenge, another challenge, another challenge, another challenge, any challenge, another challenge, another challenge, another challenge, any many challenge. Now, there must be free. Show there must be free. Show there, show there, show there must be free. Show there must be free. Show there must be free. Show there, show there, show there must be free. Nigeria must be free. Nigeria must be free. Nigeria, Nigeria, Nigeria must be free. Aluta continua. Aluta continua. Aluta, Aluta, Aluta continua.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are telling you all, please.
please do not be silent in the face of this injustice. Do not be silent in the face of tyranny. Do not be silent in the face of oppression. You need to play your part. Stand up for your rights. Encourage Nigerians to speak up for their rights. Enough of bad governance. Enough of corruption. Enough of looters in power. Enough of no light. No schools. No hospitals. No water. No hot roads. No bridges. No everything. Nothing works in that country. Enough.
Enough.
We need to stand up. I urge you all, join us.
Water run away me. When I remember Nepal, water run away me. Water run away me. When I remember no road, water run away me. Water run away me.
When I remember no.
Water run away me, ayo, aye, aye. Water run away me, ayo.
When I remember no food,
water run away me, ayo, aye, aye. Water run away me, ayo.
When I remember bad government,
water run away me, ayo, aye, aye. Water run away me, ayo.
When I remember bad roads,
water run away me, ayo, aye, aye. Water run away me, ayo.
When I remember no water,
water run away me, ayo, aye, aye. Water run away me, ayo.
Free your water
now.
Free your water
now.
Free all the activists
now. Now.
Free all the activists
now. Now.
Obey the rule of
law. Obey the rule of
law.
Obey the rule of
law.
Judiciary, arise.
Yes.
Yes, arise.
We know see you now.
Arise. Yes.
The bar, Nigerian judiciary, where are you?
Yes.
Where are you?
Arise.
The Nigerian Bar Association, where are you guys? We are not, you are silent. You need to speak up.
Yes.
The students, please speak up. Rise up. Stand up. You have a right. Sovereignty belongs to the people of the nation. We must stand up for our rights. We need to stand up for our rights.
Enough is enough.
Nigerians, wherever you are in the diaspora, you might be a British citizen, you might be an American citizen, you might be an European citizen, but let me tell you, you are a migrant. You are an immigrant. The only place you come from, they will identify you when the struggle comes. Let
Nigeria.
Me tell you,
oh, yes.
Home can never be anything but home.
Oh, yes.
We must take our country back.
Oh, yes.
Come out and speak.
Oh, yes.
We must take our country back.
Oh, yes.
Buhari, you cannot shut the voice of Nigerians.
No. Oh, yes.
You cannot shut Instagram.
No.
You cannot shut Facebook.
No.
You cannot prevent people speaking power to truth.
Oh, yes.
It is impossible.
Oh, yes.
Come out, Nigerians.
Oh, yes.
Come out, Nigerians.
Yes, yes.
When they start the exodia in South Africa,
yes.
We were hurriedly taken out. They never remember all you've done in that land.
Oh, yes.
The only place you can do something and stay with it is your country.
Oh, yes.
If I look back this way,
oh, yes.
America never got it in one day.
Oh, yes.
But how long shall this over a child to cry before he start running?
Oh, yes.
Enough is enough.
Oh, yes.
Enough,
oh, yes.
Enough,
yes.
Is enough.
Yes.
Nigeria,
oh, yes.
Must be free from the hands,
oh,
of cabal.
Yes. Yes.
There are many sovereign out there.
Nigeria must be free.
Our people
must be free. Our people must be free.
Oh.
Our people must be free.
Free Shobola
now.
Free Shobola
now.
Free Shobola
now.
Free all the activists
now.
Free all the activists
now.
Oh my home, oh my home, when shall I see my home? When shall I see my native land? I will never forget my home, Nigeria. Oh my home,
Nigeria.
Oh my home. When shall I see my home? When shall I see my native land? I will never forget my home,
Nigeria.
Owerri must be free. Aluta continua.
Revolution without ammunition. The government must obey the rule of law.
The Nigerian government must obey the rule of law. The Nigerian government must obey the rule of law. The Nigerian government must obey the judiciary. Wherever there is no law, there is no harmony. Wherever there is no law, there is no peace. Wherever there is no justice, there is no peace. Whoever is calling for peace should call for justice. That is why we are standing here today, to continue to demand that justice must prevail. Justice for one, justice for all. No one should be above the law in Nigeria. We are calling on every human being that obey the rule of law, that respect the dignity of human beings, to help us to put pressure on the government of Nigeria to make sure they obey the rule of law, to make sure they do what is right by the judiciary, to make sure that they listen to the yearnings of their citizens. Nigeria is 50, supposed to be 59 years old. But after 59, Nigeria cannot feed itself. After 59, Nigeria cannot provide education for its citizens. After 59, Nigeria has no roads. After 59, Nigeria has no airline. After 59, Nigeria cannot pay its workers less than $100 in 7 days. So that is why we are calling on every Nigerian. If you are ashamed of the situation, if you are ashamed of the problem we are facing in Nigeria today, this is the time for you to stand up. This is the time for you to be counted. This is not the time to be on the fence. This is not the time to pretend. This is not the time to say it has nothing to do with me. He has everything to do with you. If you still call yourself a human being, if you still call yourself a person that obeys the rule of law, if you still call yourself a true Nigerian, this is the time for you to stand up and be counted. We cannot longer pretend. We cannot longer accommodate this failure. We cannot longer accommodate this shambles. We cannot longer accommodate this lawlessness of Buhari government. We are calling on every Nigerian, wherever you are in the globe, stand up and be counted. Demand for what is your right. Demand for what belongs to you.
A voice for one is a voice for millions.
Nigeria belongs to all of us. That is why we must stand up and demand for justice. That is why we must stand up and demand for government accountability. That is why we must stand up and demand a government that obey the rule of law. That is why we must stand up and put an end to government of salary. That is why we must stand up and put an end to government that trample on the people's rights. Put an end to government that cannot obey.
Go to South Africa to go and beg the people that kill your people.
No one
shame on you.
Oh, Buhari should come out and speak to the citizens. He continue to flaunt the law? He continue to ignore the judiciary?
Why
he continue to flaunt the rule of law? Why he continue to trample on the judicial system of the country? We are calling on the Nigeria Bar Association. We are calling on every trade union in Nigeria. This is not the time to hide. This is not the time to pretend. You still want to see a better Nigeria, this is the time to
Enough is enough of hiding our head in the sand.
We are demanding that Sowore must be free. We are demanding that every political activist that has been detained illegally must be free. We are demanding that the government obey the rule of law. We are demanding that the government uphold the rule of law. We are demanding that the government obey the basic right of its citizens. A government that cannot put an end to terrorism, they chasing after innocent people who demand for their basic rights. A government that cannot put an end to kidnapping and detaining ordinary citizens who demand for their rights. Government that cannot put an end to insecurity and killing ordinary citizens who demand for their rights. They sending their DSS after innocent citizens who demand for their basic rights. But they cannot send their DSS after Boko Haram. They cannot send their DSS after Fulani Herdsmen. They cannot send their DSS after the kidnappings. They cannot send their DSS after all the different instances in Nigeria. That is why we are here today, demanding for our rights, demanding for what is right, demanding for justice, demanding for the Nigerian government to be accountable to its citizens, demanding for the Nigerian government to obey basic human rights, demanding for the Nigerian government to obey the rule of law, demanding for the Nigerian government to stop intimidating its citizens, to demand for an end to tyranny, to demand for Buhari to put an end to tyranny, to demand for Buhari government to be accountable to its citizens. We are standing up and calling on all of you, wherever you might be today. If you call yourself a Nigerian,
there are thousands of Sowore out there in Nigeria.
Stand up and make your
Buhari cannot keep them quiet.
Enough is enough.
Get up.
We cannot tolerate this insecurity. We cannot tolerate this injustice.
Enough
we cannot tolerate this tyranny.
It takes a man want to live and want to die. Do not be coward. Nigeria youth, do not be coward. Rise up for your rights.
It's supposed to be a democratic process. So in a democratic process, the rule of law must be obeyed. No one should be above the law. If anyone is thinking they're going to be above the law, we, the citizens of Nigeria, we're not going to be quiet. We're going to demand at 59. We cannot continue living in this shambles. After 59 years of so-called independence, we cannot continue living in this darkness. After 59 years of so-called independence, we cannot continue living in this darkness. We cannot continue living in this insecurity. That is why we are calling on every Nigerian who still have any sense of pride, any sense of shame, to stand up and be counted. To stand up and put an end to this tyranny. To stand up and question Buhari and
MPC
to be accountable to the citizens.
Enough is enough.
Nigeria does not belong to Buhari. Nigeria does not belong to MPC alone. Nigeria belongs to Nigerians. We are still inside tyranny.
We
are calling on all of you today. We are calling on you to speak. We are calling on you to stand up for what is right. Enough is enough of failure. Enough is enough of disappointment. Enough is enough of tyranny. We are calling on the government to release Sowore. To release Sowore. Sowore must be free. Sowore must be free. Sowore must be free. We demand revolution.
Now,
revolution,
now,
revolution,
now,
revolution,
now,
revolution,
now,
revolution,
now,
revolution without
ammunition,
revolution without
ammunition,
revolution without
ammunition.
Freedom come
by struggle, freedom come by struggle, freedom come,
freedom come
by struggle, freedom come by struggle. Struggle, freedom come. Sowore must be free.
right, guys, we're gonna have to I'll have to come back. I need to stop now, I need to have a break, and yeah. I might see you later on, but I'll see you on the live broadcast later on. Thank you very much. Free show we're there now. Free all the activists now. Free show we're there now. The government must accept the court decisions.
Yes.
The government must comply with the court decisions. Yes. Now. No more excuses. We have nothing to celebrate at 59. Yes.
The lawmakers cannot be the lawbreakers.
Exactly.
Where there is no law, there is chaos.
Exactly. Oh,
yeah. Where there is no law, there is no peace.
Exactly.
Where there is no law, there is anarchy.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. We are calling that the government should be accountable.
Exactly.
No one holds Nigeria more than the other.
Exactly.
All of us as a Nigeria have a stake in Nigeria.
Exactly.
We have the right to demand for good governance.
Yes.
We have the right to demand for justice.
Yes.
We have the right to demand for equity.
Yes.
We have the right to demand for the government to uphold the rule of law.
Yes.
And that is why we are saying, preach your word
now.
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 You will hear back from us.
We'll come back later on. Thank you very much. Cheers. Talk soon.